Hopefully this is working. Hi. Hi everyone. I am neither a teenager nor a troublemaker, but I am the guy who runs the games. My name's Josh. Good to meet you. Basically, this will be the beginning of a series, me just live streaming a game. Live play, or straight play. Gameplay. What do you people call this? You people. It's a let's play. Let us play a game. It's not us, it's me. I'm going to be playing right now Baldur's Gate 3, because it's closely enough related to 5e, Dungeons and Dragons, the game, you know, and it's also an excuse to justify this overly costly computer that I just put together. And also to create content, and also because it's something I want to do because I think it'd be fun. Eventually, hopefully, all of us who are part of the Teenagers and Troublemakers family will be involved in some way, whether we are posting our own stuff or all together as a group, ideally. Of course, that would be even more expensive and harder to organize and make a reality. But we're working there. Also, the other thing I was going to say, and 99% of the time, this stuff will also be streamed live on Twitch. The account I'm currently using is, Reburied Occult, which is the company that produces, Teenagers and Troublemakers and anything else that we create. Because Teenagers and Troublemakers is the name of the podcast and those particular episodes. But Reburied Occult will be anything else that is the umbrella. But yeah, this has gone on long enough. I have no idea if it was even recorded well. Everything's an experiment at this stage. But have fun watching me make faces and make silly voices while playing a video game that's still in early access. Okay, hopefully this is working because I'm gonna keep going for quite some time. Let's see. We are gonna start a new game because the other ones are practically unusable at this point. But I'm gonna try to remember all the terrible jokes I said the first time around and say them as if they are new. Because, you know, that's how you get good at something. Practice, 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 practice. I'm gonna check. Oh yeah, I forgot. Cinema scenes. All right, so we have Gandalf, and these are clearly where hobbits are grown. Ooh, a polypanus. Ew. Floaty boy. I'm going to say my complaints about Githyanki in a second, but you know what? I'll go ahead and start it. I know it's supposed to be a super dramatic scene, but I want certain creatures to be weird and alien, and I don't think the Githyanki or these squidbillies are freaky enough. Also, he's dropping the kids off of the pool. That's sperm. Sperm or poopy. Anyway, so Githyanki should have knobby knees and elbows, and they should be freakishly have like no noses, and the squid people should have atrophied legs and limbs because they don't use them. But instead, everybody's got big old musco legs. Ooh. That's the worst part. Those things have hair. It's the worst part. It's so gross. And this is supposed to be us. I mean, don't choose for me, game. I might be into this. Let me make that decision. And that is that's how sperm really is. So, abstinence is the best choice. Sperm is from. I get to make my character again. Okay. Shh. Was that a different voice than last time? Oh, wow, this is creepy. Anyway, Ooh, look. Gives the peace sign. All right, so the idea is we attempted this last time. Gonna do it again. I'm gonna try to recreate the only D&D character I've been able to play as in a game I actually wasn't the DM, and the longest running D&D game I got to be in. I got all the way to the 10th level, and that's what we're gonna try to recreate. We're gonna try to recreate my tiefling ranger Anku, even though a lot of what he could do won't be available, but we're still gonna try to recreate him. So first, we're gonna go, we can't pick any of these people. It's fine. He was a male, from as far as anybody can tell. He was a male. His name is not Tav, it's Anku, which is, I forgot what, it's like a devil, not a devil, he's like an undead spirit thing who collected murdered victims. I forget, I actually forgot the country and stuff. I might look up the book in a little bit, where I got the information from. In the game that I played, he actually was an acolyte, only because he was raised in a church against, he didn't want to be. He was left there as a baby. The idea is that, you know, nobody wanted a devil baby, so they left him and he had to, but it does give him insight and religion proficiency. We'll go with that for now, because once again, this is not about optimization, this is about staying true to the character. And unfortunately, he did have religion. We'll figure it out. Lady is singing in the background. So we go on to next. He was absolutely a tiefling. And I have some. Okay, so there's three different versions of tieflings you can pick. So, Mistopheles. Isn't that the guy from Cats? Zariel. Asmodeus. I think when I picked a tiefling, there weren't all these options. So we're going to go by what bonuses he gets. My guy had more intelligence than he had strength, so he'll probably end up being Asmodeus. He did have thaumaturgy, even though, oh my god, I do want Mage Hand. I want it so bad. But, no. He definitely was more of the intelligent type than the, God, I really do want that. Thinking. But my guy didn't have that, so that's why I keep going back and forth. Manifest a sign of supernatural power that gives you intimidation. You know what? Yeah, he was more intimidating than anything else, so we'll go with that. Fine. He's got that. We're gonna create how he looks. Now, I did this already. I don't like either of these male voices.
House.
A tidy slot.
A tidy house. Slot. Perverts.
Something just woke up down here.
There goes, who woke up down here?
The stone's less worn here.
That one. We'll go with the... Stone's less worn. We'll go with house. That one.
Something just woke up down here.
Head. Head. Pants. New. If I remember correctly, I like the one with the extra horny bits. I do like the extra horny bits. Just because it looks messy and sloppy. Ooh, that one's not so bad, actually. It's got a little bit of extra horny stuff. Not too well. No. Maybe not. Nope. I was wrong. I just can't read graphics at all. Probably going to go with the extra horny bits. Just because of that. Yep. Extra horny bits it is. Horns... Okay, my guy Anku had one full horn, the other one was broken. Wasn't gone, it was just broken, because of an accident, but that option isn't here. So we'll have to go with one that's visually appealing. Actually, that one's not that bad. Might go with that guy. I already forgot which ones I went with last time. Jinx, what are you doing? All skin colors, because I did not really care for the way he looked last time. I might go with something weirder this time. Yeah. Definitely don't want... No. Ooh. Actually, you know what? Anku wasn't that pale, though. He had a form of a rustic. Actually, I might just go back with this color again, because it... Yeah. It's too red. It's just such a cliche color. down by the river. Creepy lady singing your creepy song. What river is she talking about? You know what? I might just pick a weird color like that. Because he's a reflection of me, he's pale, and he looks like he's dying. He's suffocating, that's why his lips are turning blue. And when I'm in water for too long and freezing, that's what happens. Hey, Jess.
Yeah?
Is it annoying as hell that it looks like I'm just talking to myself?
No.
You weren't even paying attention. You're not even paying attention. I'm literally talking to myself. Nobody's watching this.
I feel like
a slightly crazy person, even though it's like, who cares? Like, I don't know.
No, my friend Seb, this is like a couple years ago or something.
You're being recorded, by the way.
That's funny. A couple years ago or something. I literally talk to myself
all the time, yeah.
Constantly, and in the car, always out loud, like always.
You know what I've told people whenever they're super self-conscious about that? I'm like, okay, then sing to yourself.
Exactly.
Like literally, nobody thinks twice when I mean, it might be like, oh, wish they'd shut up, but it's never, ooh, they're crazy. It's just they sing those. But when you talk to yourself, people are like, ugh.
Yeah. What's wrong with you?
Okay, I want this guy to have really crazy eyes. They won't stand out as much because he's not dark-skinned like he was last time. Well, I have green eyes. I wonder if I should give him... No, we don't want boring green eyes. We want freakish green eyes. Because he's got a tadpole in his freaking brain, man. You know what? I'm about to walk away from the stream for half a second because, I want something to drink. Hairstyles. Okay, last time I went with big old dreddy locks, but this game a bit too much clipping for my taste. There's those beautiful dreads. We'll see what else we got. Body locks. Actually, if my hair's short, that's not too... I will murder you. Why would you want to be near me? Ew. We are not going for... Actually, feels a little kinkier. I kind of like that it wobbles. Wobble, 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 wobble. Wobble, 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 wobble. I might just go with that. I do like the luscious mane of locks, though. But see, there's no wobble. Wobble, wobble, wobble. Is there wobble? Do they have wobble? Wobble, wobble. Nope, no. Yep, we're going to go with the wobble. Gotta have the wobble. He has a wobbly tail, he has a wobbly hair. Wobble, 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 wobble. Shut up, cat! Now, last time I gave him a... I don't know if I like him with a beard. King Beardsley. I don't know. I mean, it doesn't look bad, but when the gameplay is happening, it's just like... And you can't shave in the game. You're stuck with this look forever. Maybe I should just go with a funny hairstyle. Something scruffy. He would be scruffy. That's pretty scruffy. I don't know. Let's see what else we got. He looks like a billy goat. Billy! Anyway. I still like the old colonel. Oh well, I'm just a southern gentleman. Don't mind me. I think we're gonna go, even though I know I'm gonna regret giving him facial hair, we're gonna go with this weird scruffy mess here, because he's a mess of a man. He's a messy boy. He's a messy bitch. How you like my guy? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he looks awesome. Nice cheekbones.
I know, right? It's like, oh. Anyway, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just goofing off.
I think for what you do, it's good to talk to yourself, because that's just even more practice, you know?
That is true. I do need the practice in doing different voices.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Normal.
Normal from Garfield. The lasagna cat. Should his hair match his skin? No. I don't like that. That's a Caduceus look right there, but we're not trying to be Caduceus. We're trying to be Anku. And Anku is a bit He's a bit darker, but not really. He's actually a pretty lighthearted guy. He's sick of the system that he works for. Weird blonde. That makes him look like an albino.
I've got no pigment in my skin.
You know what? I might just give him a weird green hair look, because, you know what? Why not? Bouncy green hair. Yeah, that's a bit too much. You know what? That's what we're about to go with. That's how Anku looks in this world. Tattoo. Probably give him the same tattoo I got earlier. The first time around before I realized how bad this stream was looking. Where's the little eyeball tattoo? Little tears you get under your eye when you're in prison and your family's dead. The neck tattoo would be great if you could see his flipping neck. Tattoo intensity. Wish that added more. It needs to stand out there. So last time he was dark skinned, so white stood out fantastic. But he might go with red, just because it stands out a little more. Yep, red it is. Makeup. This pasty pale skin could use some makeup. Let's go with orange so it stands out so we can see it. Ooh, he's a fiery one. Yeah, that's a little bit much. That one's actually pretty subtle. It's got a little dot. Okay with that. Let's see what other colors we got. Green for his green eyes. Retina. I don't know. I think that's nice and subtle. Just a touch. Just a touch. Let's go to class. Let's make him a classy bastard. Ranger. He was always a ranger. He was a bounty hunter. Let's see. He was a bounty hunter. He specifically hunted people in cities. An expert at navigating the wild within the city. But anyway, he'll have his thieves, tools, abilities, investigation, sleight of hand, and all this other stuff. Okay, so everything so far is lining up pretty close. Too bad he can't be his third level thing, but it's okay. I'll try to pretend like I don't know stuff about this game already. Inherited skills. From who? Daddy. Sleight of hand, investigation, religion, insight. Granted from passive? Who's passive? Pappy? Inherit from background, investigation. Can I turn it off? No. Survival. Okay, stealth makes sense. Perception makes sense. He wouldn't do so much nature, not so much athletics, and not animal handling, but he would have survival. Yeah. So far, I'm a... Yeah. And what is his old doodad to do again? Let's see here. Grant you an advantage on intimidation performance check. So two things he's not actually good at, but when he wants to use... Yeah, actually, you know what? That kind of falls in line with the way the character was. He did occasionally flare up his eyeballs to be all pissy. We're going to reset this all the way down as low as it can get. Okay, originally, here's the thing. Anku did not have good... Because I roll... God, I wish this game would let you roll. Or just punch in the numbers that you want. Because his dexterity, I believe, was only a 15 the first time around, which it can only go up to 15. His wisdom was also a 15, if I remember correctly. But his other numbers won't be high enough, so we're gonna have to do with that. Like, charisma, let's see, strength. I mean, he wasn't weak, he just wasn't super strong either. Constitution. Okay, what does recommended say? Recommended says constitution plus 13. See, but he was smart. He was actually pretty smart. He actually, if anything, his charisma was low and his intelligence was higher. His strength. I know in the game that matters, but it's not really. Anyway, we'll just make his charisma kinda low. He wasn't the most charming of fellas. Even though I know it's gonna come to bite me in the butt at some point. Wisdom. I mean, that's helpful for what he is. Intelligence. I know at some point you get to do a plus one to your ability, so. We'll just leave it the way it is strength. Fine, I'll leave it a plus one. I mean, even though I'm pretty sure it wasn't. Nope. His strength will be a 10. And his charisma will be a plus one. Because that is more in line with how the character originally was. Yeah. Yeah, I do believe we are done. I'm about to disappear for, I gotta get something to drink. Other than aqua.
Crackers and soda. Crackers and soda, indeed.
I am going to double check something for a second. Don't mind me. I'm just going to press buttons. Okay. Hopefully that's working. Anyway, venture forth.
Tell me, who do you dream of at night?
Ooh. I actually forgot about this part. Who does he dream about at night? Why can't it be during the day? Who do you dream about all day long? I want a short, stocky lady. Actually, she's pretty dang close to what, it's very, well, at least they're wearing underpants. So let's go with a dwarf, a short, stocky woman with strong, sturdy legs like Miss Piggy. He likes the, ooh, what is it? Shield dwarves survive a long fall from grace, surrendering many of their ancient kingdoms in wars with goblins and orcs. These losses have led to a cynical mindset, yet shield dwarves will endure anything to restore their ancestral homelands. Okay.
Gold dwarves are known for their confidence and keen intuition. The culture of the Deep Kingdom values family ritual and fine craftsmanship.
You know what? Anku is in, he did build some stuff back in the D&D games when you could do that. What? Look, I forgot about Mini Zeus. Oh my goodness, look at that chest and shoulder hair. Oh yeah, and the one nipple will stick it out at ya. Gonna poke you in the eye. Oh, it's a 2D graphic. Nope, no pokey nipples here. But anyway, we're gonna go with the lady dwarf. We're gonna go with voices.
Stones less warm here.
Eh.
A tidy slot.
A tidy slot. Ooh, ew. Mm-mm. Anyway, I'm sure nobody else has ever done that joke. Heed. They almost look all the same. You know what I'm gonna go with? The one with the freckles. Cause yeah, a little bit of, I mean, face is just all right, but freckles add a little bit more. We're gonna give her a nice tan, cause I do like a lady with some skin tone. Yeah, that's good enough. Darker? Ooh, can we go super dark? Ooh. The river. Okay, well, she's just freaking... She's like made out of stone. She's a stony lady. That one's not bad. Of course, with the freckles, it don't look so good. I don't know, these faces are just okay. You know what? It doesn't matter. It doesn't really matter, but she's gonna have some crazy eyes. Got to have the crazy eyes. Yeah, glowing red eyes. My kind of lady. Let's see. Crazy orange eyes? Matches her dress. I'm okay with that. Weird orange eyes. You bet you slit me in my throat. What, lady? No. 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 I like a shortcut. I forgot about that. Oh, yeah, there's that one. I know which one I'm going to pick. The one that's like that, but a little bit shaved. It's somewhere in here. There we go. Yeah. And I'm so tempted to give her a beard. Just unbelievably tempted. But I already have a beard, and we don't need, like, that's just Velcro will be attached and will never let go. Hair color. Should be a weird color, or an... Actually, I was pretty partial to the blonde, the platinum blonde we had going on a minute ago. You know what? I'm fine with that. Yeah, she should have a tattoo. She should have a badass tattoo. Squidward! Well, she did have a matching eyebrow tattoo that was the... Maybe, ooh, I can actually see her neck tattoo. You know what? We're about to go with that fancy neck tattoo. We're going where? Oh, by the river. Where else would we go? And she's gonna have some eye makeups. Ew, I do not like the way this is looking. Maybe we should give it. You know what? I'm fine with that. Not really, actually, I'm not. You know what? She's gonna go all natural. She is an all natural lady. No makeup for... Wait a minute, how do I get rid of this? Oh yeah. No makeup. She's perfect the way she is. I believe we are ready to go. Let's venture forth. While I sip my soda. You know, after being penetrated in my eyeball by this unnecessarily muscular alien leg guy. Oh, damn it, Frank. Sleep on the job again. Let me just go to my penal chair and...
Whee! Open up the windows.
What little boy, or what is it? What did you find? A mollusker I found on the ground. I can't remember. How can I not remember that song right now? Hey, it's that guy from the trailer. And he drops his weapon, which I still think was not a smart move. Literally the one thing that might help you right now. And by the time you get to that bell, pretty sure everyone in the town is quite well aware of the giant mollusk flying overhead. And while this is happening, I'm gonna check my phone, because I've gotten some messages. Audio sounds pretty crisp to me. Thank you, Trinity. You're hurling? Is it that bad? Of course, you sent that like 20-something minutes ago, but... Trinity, let Jordan know. I don't think he knows what's happening. And if you're wondering, I'm not, like... Ooh, I missed a group chat? How did I do that? Let's see. Anyway. Oh, what did I miss? Okay. Oh yeah, this guy. Very invested in his story. Sad to see... Oh, thank God he survived. I was very worried. I'm sure he was a good guy. Riding a red dragon. Also, he's a Yankee. They're generally jerks. Ooh. Dragons just are not that majestic fly. Like, their legs just, like, hang. I mean, you know, it's one of those things where it's like, where do you put your arms and legs when you're in flight? But it just looks, it looks gangly. Maybe they'd be like turtles and they tuck them in. I wish that's how I would design dragons. Hey, dragons, fly above the canyon. Above. Like, he can't go anywhere. Anyway. Hi, guys!
Oh, yeah.
Pull up! No, the babies! The precious babies. You needed to get my attention? Well, guess what? I didn't see it. I just happened to... I've already seen this opening sequence a couple of times, so I'm like, meh. Yeah, it's old hat. Meh. Yeah. There's Peter Pantless. So how does the video look on your end, Miss Trinity? Look, like, it's like part her whole butt cheek's hanging out. Surprise you. How did you survive not getting burned? The number three! Imps away! Ooh, Trinity says it looks crisp. Well, I'm glad it looks good to you. Now, hey Trinity, here's the thing. Oh wait, stuff's happening. Does it look good enough that people aren't gonna have a headache watching it? Oh, my head! The door is open!
You've poisoned me for the last time, you rotten girl.
Alright, let's see if I can recreate the scenario that happened last time. Last time I played this game, my very first roll was a natural 20. It'll just take everything that happens in the game from here on out. Alright, so first, check my mind.
I'd still be stuck inside if we hadn't been attacked.
Might have still been stuck inside if I had not been attacked.
First, let's save a game, just to be on the safe side. New save. You know what? Just a regular old save. I'm not that worried about it. Deals 1d4 fire damage. It's always good to know how badly something will hurt you. I wish more relationships were like that. Auto save successful. Alright, and I'm gonna clicky on the nursery? It's called the nursery.
This is the pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye.
Why won't you look at it? Look at it! He's so disgusted with it, he can't even look. Also, what makes this funny is I'm going to act like I'm saying the narrator's voice is it. Of course, I'm going to investigate the poo. Another natural 20? Oh! Barely made it.
The casing is fragile. The slightest touch could cause it to crumble.
Well... Don't you dare look at it. Break your neck looking at anything else. Of course I'm going to touch it.
Its casing crumbles beneath your hands, sloshing.
Who could have seen this coming? And I took no damage. Heck yeah. I'm gonna check this here dead body. Hello! Void Bulb creates a force that pulls in all nearby, unaffixed items. The numerous suction cups on this ball expand and constrict rhythmically, as if breathing or in a rave, club, dance, hall. They latch on to anything they can get hold of. What is this? Potion of Speed. This solution ripples and splashes of its own accord, almost like it's trying to escape the bottle. Then don't let it out.
Dead. Good.
Dead! Good! Oh, look at the briny bulbs. What are they doing? Hi. I know, get the, like, my guy, like, take this briny bulb. Boom! I just wanted to do that. I thought it would be funny, and I was correct.
Someone else got out.
Someone else did get out. Is it just me or does the audio seem a little low? I don't know, it could be just me. Caretaker Thrall.
How on earth will I get over there? Can't reach. Good thing I have the jump.
I should be... Let's see here. No, not dash. Jump. Whee! Over the fire. Heck yeah! I didn't even see this last time. Slave mind? Let's examine that. It weighs way too much. A humanoid brain alive and in perfect condition suspended in cerebral. I mispronounced the word already. Cerebrospinal fluid. I don't know what I should do with that. Can I put it back in his body? I'll carry it.
Brain in a jar.
Thank you. Thank you for telling me that. Now I'm gonna walk over this and get burned. Can you do anything to put flames out? I guess not.
I have resistance to fire.
Let's see, did I get any other Missy G's? I got one.
Goo.
Getting more positive affirmations from my daughter. That's the only reason I had kids. Positive affirmations.
Shut up! You can't learn nothing if you don't get burned. Or something like that.
Ugh, why are these chests disgusting? Potions. The flesh-like lid of this rubbery container seems to quiver when touched. It's a vagina. Stay away from it, son. It's evil. It's an angry vagina. The only type of vaginas there are. Yeah, pick up a cock. Just gonna pick everything up. Don't even care what it is. How is this stuff not dangerous? It's the poop machine. Who doesn't have a spare bottle of grease on hand at any given moment? Do we use it? Is it like, Dapper Dan's? Anyway, let's see, jump. I think you're gonna jump, not enough space. There's plenty of space, come on. Ah, you dingbat. Get over there. Whee! Hey, you made your deck save, or whatever.
Might be other survivors.
Dee 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 dee. I wonder which way to go next. Well, time to check the map. I have been everywhere.
I feel better.
That is odd. Maybe we should not do that ever again. This is not
supposed to be for feeling good.
Dee dee dee. Lots of dead bodies.
Devilkin. Am I in the hells?
Perhaps. Yeah. Oh, and something else I'm gonna desperately try to do in this game is to stick with my terrible choices. I'm gonna do my best not to, scum save. Even though I might be tempted on occasion. I will sit in this chair though, because it's got holes in it. Perfect for it. It hurt? Or did I hurt the What? Did I hurt the chair? What just happened? I do want to pick up this hollow shell though. Is it vicious or viscous? Viscous chair. Okay.
Images of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind.
With a strange fixation on their mating habits. A lot more bones and gristle than you would imagine. Screw the firebolt. Hurl a mote of fire that deals 1d6 fire damage and creates a flammable surface. I wonder why they lowered it. It's supposed to be 1d10. Why? I'm gonna pick up this caustic bowl.
Curious.
Curiouser and curiouser. A mucus shield. Mucoid. So daylight? It's like a walker. Barbed device. Sure, why not? Carrying us all this crap.
Brains.
Let's see, it's an aquarium. Where exactly do you see a brain, dude? I just see an aquarium, anyway. I don't think you know what you're talking about.
1,000 years of humanoid history. Elves, dwarves, humans, and more flash behind your eyes.
You know what? Before, the audio in this thing was loud. Now it's kind of low. I'm going to rectify that.
Turn it up. Ooh. Let's try that.
Accept. I accept you.
Faint images appear in your mind. A brain, a gift.
Just a brain. Pinky in the brain.
Centuries of darkness.
Centuries of darkness? What's the difference between this brain and the other mind?
Dark mind.
I mean, sure. Why not?
Another brain.
Yep. Another brain. What am I carrying exactly? A bar. The surface of this contraption has the consistency of dried phlegm. It's a plumbus. The blue streaks lining this shell secrete a sweet-smelling slime. Oh, yeah. Barely, Levon. What are you going to do with $260 worth of pudding? Don't worry your pretty head about it. Aw, oh, yeah. There's another knocked-over chair. What else? Shut up, child! I don't like children at the best of times, and this certainly ain't it. Neural apparatus.
Doesn't do anything.
Because you don't know what you're doing. Shh! Shh! His very... Ooh, another chest. Another fleshy chest.
Release us.
Shh! Parents slip these stones under the children's pillows to ward off nightmares. For 25 gold? Why would they... Man, that kid ain't worth all that.
We are here.
Shh! Silencio, por favor. I'm checking for more brains. A tentacle aquarium? That's gotta be different than the brain aquarium.
Brains?
No!
Trapped.
It specifically says tentacles. Soft to the touch and covered with a thin layer of colorless slime. So clear, translucent maybe. I guess we'll deal with this guy. F5, good old quick save just in case something crazy happens. Ooh, that guy's got some abs. I bet everybody in this game has nice bodies. Disgusting.
You've come to save us from this place. From this place you'll free us.
Mm.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return.
Did I have to do a perception check to do that? I think you're past the point of saving. Tell me what to do.
Remove us from this body. From this case. Free us. Please.
Who am I talking to? A man or a brain?
A newborn. Born new from this husk.
You know no creature like this.
Aww.
One that is more brain than person.
Well, I did last time. Inspect the exposed brain.
Break the skull.
Gently prise the brain from the skull.
Let's see. Ooh, it shows your numbers and everything. That is nice, because normally you have your character sheet. So +3. This one should be higher.
Only a +2?
What? And that one's just a straight roll, because your old strength sucks, son. Inspect the exposed brain.
Press space bar.
All right.
Notice edema, a swelling of the brain causing pressure where it strains against the shell of the skull.
Ew, it's like a baby coming in the wrong way out of the birth canal.
Before they return!
Who is they?
They return.
Alright, so what am I good at? +2 from wisdom, so... And I get advantage? Oh, that's pretty swell. Yeah.
Attempt a cerebral extraction, staying mindful of the swelling.
Because I'm a flippin' doctor. But it said I had advantage. Heck yeah. Do I get to roll again? Oh. Ew. Dude, you need a dent. Oh, actually, your teeth are pretty good. You need a jawist.
The brain lifts from the skull, but you notice an opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient should it prove a threat.
How on earth would you know this?
I mean, my guy's not that awful of a human being. Oh, goodness, I'm tempted. Spare the creature. Any injuries might weaken it. I'm not that much of a bastard. Not unless you've done something to me to deserve it. Yee!
Her first steps!
Our freedom is ours, friend!
The creature pauses, listening. Something behind your eyes seizes.
We must go to the helm!
At the helm, we are needed.
Ew. Attack the brain! I do that every day with alcohol. What should I call you?
We are us.
I haven't seen that movie yet. No spoilers. I feel bad. I wanted to see it in the theaters too, but I didn't get a chance. I helped you once. That's all I could do. What's
at the helm? What's at the helm?
The brain tenses, as though querying an unseen advisor.
Who's sending
you
this?
Do you not hear it? We will not survive here. We are needed to navigate. We are needed to leave this realm.
Trinity, you didn't like the baby being born and then getting its first legs? That's what it was like when you were born. You came out with no arms and legs, and then they popped out seconds afterwards. That's exactly how you were born. Okay, I wasn't paying attention.
Do not hear it. We will not survive here. We are needed to navigate. We are needed to leave this realm.
That's all I heard.
All right, let's go, Fido.
To the helm we go.
To the helm we go. To the helm we go. We're traveling through hell. Why'd you fall like that, dude? Ew, what is this? A condition. Newborn. For four... Oh, gathering its bearings. Disadvantage on attack rolls, lowered armor class, and hit points cannot take... Apparently, it only takes 6 times 4, whatever that number is. 24, 25, 27, 30. I'm bad with math. And soon, the creature will become far more powerful than I could ever imagine. Come on, Mr. Brain! Oh, I guess Mr. Brain will be up there forever. Mr. Us... Is the brain really stuck up there? He has more hit. A newborn brain has more hit points than me. That's messed up, man. Can I go to the character sheet? Oh, he's sneaking. Woo! Brain's got its own sheet. Let's see here. Can we give him weapons? Us, level 1. Not much strength. Got some dexterity, though. Got some... You don't have hardly any intelligence? It's male. You are male of one of these races. You perceived as male by those you encounter. Oh, sure. A servant of mind flayers that feeds on the intelligence of sentient beings. This is fantastic. I got a brain buddy. Oh, he can jump. And he can hide. Sneak, 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 sneak. Alright. Me and my brain buddy. Can I not select both of them at the same time? I guess it doesn't work that way. This isn't one of those games. Quick save, just because I'm paranoid. Doesn't look like there's anything else in the room. I've gotten all the... Check out the map real fast. Don't see any other... What's that over there? Something we can't get to yet. At least not as far as I'm aware. Let's check the map real quick. Yeah.
it's a rap. It's Jurassic Park.
Well, Mr. Brain, it's end of the line. I'm about to shove you off this thing. Let's see here. Jump.
Whee!
He did it on his own. That had to be told. Such a clever creature. Clever boy. Do 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 do. Oh, autosave. Dude. Whoa! What the hell, lady?
Abomination. This is your end.
How'd you know my nickname?
Your head throbs and your skin tingles. Visions rush past. The dragon's wing. A silver sword. And a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this? You are no thrall. Flacketh blesses me this day.
You say so.
Together,
crazy.
We might survive. Imps block the path for
Peter Pantless.
You will assist me in destroying them. We must reach the helm before we transform.
Transform? Like Transformers?
Transform? What do you mean?
We carry mind flay of parasites. Unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geich, mind flayers.
And a mind flayer is... Who are you?
Who am I?
Yes.
Your only chance of survival, and you mine.
I got my brain, buddy. I don't need you.
We are turning into mind flayers. There must be something we can do.
And I'm talking with food in my mouth.
We can do nothing until we escape. That must be our priority.
You have yours. I have mine. I might be okay with turning into a mind flayer. I like having pineal glands hanging off my face. Yes, Scully, go potty.
Is the helm our way out of here?
It is where we might gain control of the Ga'ath, the ship. Once in command, we will deal with our Geich captors.
Are you tired of hearing me talk, lady?
Onward, then.
First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. As for that thing, it will remain tame as long as it believes we are thralls. It may be of use in the fight to come.
Don't you call my brain buddy Fang.
Jerk.
I mean, you both have something in common. You're not wearing pants. Combat turns. Oh, I forgot to be sneaky. Oh well. The enemy is surprised. Combat happens in turns. Each turn you can do one action and one bonus action, which probably doesn't translate well to a video game, because that is a paper, pen and paper, part of the stomach. You can also move. A roll of the die decides. Turn already. This is called initiative and is influenced by your dexterity. Your available actions are highlighted.
Bonus actions are actions you can perform on top of your normal actions.
I'm not gonna do that with my voice. The movement bar shows how much distance you can cover during your turn. If you say so.
Characters in the same party that are next to each other in the initiative order can act at the same time.
You should have combos. Combos. Alright, so what are we doing? If I remember correctly, they only have resistance to fire, as do I. So first, I'm gonna walk over here next to this here fire. Fire burns. I'm gonna dip my here weapon. Where's the dip? Where's the dip? Where's the dip? Dip, dip. Already lost. Dip. Dip it in the flames. Yeah. And then I'm gonna aim right here, and I'm gonna fire my bow and arrow right here. Kick ya! Boom! Wait a minute. Did I just do something I didn't mean to do? I think I did. Oh well.
That is the end of my turn.
I do believe, unless I wanna. Yeah, that's it.
Mr. Brains!
What is he gonna do?
Claws?
That's not all he can do? Boo. He's got more health than anybody else, and he is a newborn. looks like a dog. Yeah, dash. Beep, 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 beep. Yoink. 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 That's good. And now crazy lady here is gonna run over here, even though she doesn't have enough movement. You know what? She'll bow and arrow it up too.
All right, who do we have next?
Oh, we're back to her again. Oh, she didn't do anything. She's nothing to dip it in, so end of turn.
It's the imps.
I want that imp's crossbow. That's what I want. Mm-hmm. I do like hiding next to Flame.
Makes me feel like a man.
Dropping like flying deer. And what else can you do? Well, that's about it. Let's see here. Climb up here, lady. Get your arrow on. Yeah! Better than nothing.
Don't hurt the baby.
Doink. Oh, come on. Come on now, Cracker. Cracker Jack. Easy. What are you gonna do there, kid? Can I shove you? You're not close enough? Yeah, I guess I can't shove. I'm gonna swat. That's not the most exciting thing, but. Surprisingly adequate in battle. Thanks, lady.
Now, to the helm.
I literally came equipped with weapons from the birthing pod. But whatever you say. Come to collect.
I was promised chocolate, and I've come to collect.
I mean, I'll take it, he doesn't want it, but... What is this? Nautiloid tank. Ooh, can I talk? Heck yeah.
The creature reaches inside your mind, its thoughts rattling against yours. Something inside you squirms in recognition.
He's like, wait a second, I love that
friend,
tune.
We will go to the helm now.
Sure.
Why was I forced onto this ship?
To know you. To love you.
Aww.
To give you our gift.
It's my birthday. Shoved you which put in my eye. What was it?
A gift. A gift to make you as we are. Soon you will be so beautiful, so powerful.
That doesn't sound bad. Can you tell me where we are?
In a realm where we have fled. We have fled to a realm called Avernus, first of the Nine Hells. We are escaping a great evil. We are going to the helm! Going to the helm.
Not now. We must go to the helm.
Damn you, Peter Patchless. You're relentless.
Alright. What else have we got around here? Oh, wait. I don't want to go that way yet. I gotta check everything else first. I'm not new to RPGs, there's always more nooks and crannies to look upon. Nooks and grannies. What are you? Get over here. There you go. You took a long way around, but yeah, sure. Intellect devour. Yes. Well, if it was already empty, why didn't you say that before I clicked on it? Oh, look, the Mind Flayer has some things. Poisoned Mind Flayer. As opposed to all the ones that worked, apparently. Oh yeah, I forgot. Low strength means you can't carry much. Oh well. I'll have to live with my choices. He's weak because he's you know what? He's had the flu. He's weak. That's my in-game explanation. We're gonna go this way. Because this... I've already played this part and I know there's a dead body on this side. Walking up the dead side of the... Check this dead body. Stuff. Ooh, redhead lady. Roar!
Yes, they're beautiful. Pew pew pew! Pew 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 pew!
Looks like he's badly climbing a set of a ladder.
Whee!
Doink. To the ground you stay. Nope. You don't get to get back up. Can I talk to my farmer lady now?
Boo got me. Got me. Right in the gut.
Did he get you?
Tell the base I'll be all right. The mind players have already enthralled her. Leave her. We will share her fate.
I mean, I am a submissive in certain scenarios.
Mugwort bundle. It's what I've always wanted.
Can you check the thing I told you to? Oh, thank you.
A rogue's favorite toy.
You are gonna carry that? Yeah, that looks good. Let's see. Light, and that does not count as light, but it is versatile.
Thrall caretaker.
Ooh. What is an hour mind? An eldritch brain, alive and in perfect condition, suspended in cerebral vital fluid. Sure. Oh, I want one of these things.
Beep, beep, pew!
I'm Ding of the World. Aha. Hey! Well, oh shit, my little buddy's on fire. Maybe you should have walked through literal fire, you dingus. No! There we go. You... I was literally trying to keep you from catching on fire, but yeah, you're about to die. This game is ridiculous. You can't do anything about putting people out. Get over here, lady!
Everybody's on fire!
Let's go down here and heal everybody.
Everybody take five. Regularly scheduled breaks are important for productivity.
Yeah, stay on. Oh, I gotta practice that voice.
What's next?
Oh, how could I miss the baker? Or the barker?
Well, I'll lend a hand, won't you, love?
Love.
There's a rat in the kitchen. 10 red rats. And they're flying and they're clawing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Do go on. A blast. I mean, that makes it sound like I could do something with it. I can't do anything with it. Don't show me a blast cannon and then don't let me do anything with it. Jerks. I'm going to hide because apparently they can't see me, which makes no sense. And I'm going to come over here and I'm going to dippy dip my weapon. Dippy dip. Dippy dippy dip. Because that makes sense. And knock him unconscious by stabbing him to death. I'm surprised? How is he surprised? Anyway, this game don't make no sense. But whose turn is it? I can't do anything. How am I?
My baby brain.
You're gonna go with the one, the big old sword. You're gonna go with the big old sword, and you're gonna chop that guy. Mmm, beautiful. I'm gonna check that body, since I know that doesn't take up turns anymore. Because I did this before, because I cheated. And I'm going to, come up behind you. Come up behind you right there. And I'm gonna stab you right there in the back. Yeah? What you gonna do about it? Kinda wanted that axe that's, hanging on your back there, but, we'll talk to this student.
I'm a bit peaked, Mom. I think I'll go to bed early.
Lucky.
Wish I could go to bed early.
Oh, it's the old battle axe. Would you mind pick... No, I was trying to give it to the lady.
Give the battle axe to the lady. Ooh, give it to the brain. I want the brain to use it. She can have the longsword too, because I don't need to carry all that. Let's see here. There we go. That. Go to the, press the B button. Go to good old Lazelle. Something like that. Oh, look at all this stuff. Githya and Gear are peerless warriors from the astral plane, known for their legendary silver blades and red dragon mouth. They seek the total destruction of Mind Flayers, whose ancient empire enslaved the Githyankis for millennia. I mean, there's also the other type of Gith, but you know, whatever. Anyway, we want to go to her inventory. I don't know these buttons. I'll figure them out eventually. There we go. I like the idea of her having a big old meaty axe, because it makes her so much more interesting. And as far as you, like I'm missing something. Probably am. My phone keeps going off. Who's messaging me? Jordan's watching. Yay. Hello, Jordan. How does the game look to you, Jordan? Let me know in the comments below. Actually, I just want to know so we can. I can improve things where they need to be. Pierce throw. A pretty necklace. That is what I was looking for a minute ago. He is going to wear a very pretty necklace. Boom. Can't believe it doesn't show up on his body. It's disgusting. Anyway, what else we got? Wounded imp, already checked his body, already checked you. Checked you, apparently. An intellect evaluator. There's nothing there. It's very disappointing.
To the helm. You are needed to survive.
Aww, you care.
Yes, the helm.
I didn't say anything. Following you doesn't seem like a good idea.
Imperfect.
Yes, we all are.
Fine.
Do not delay.
Don't tell me what to do. Don't you dare presume to tell me what to do.
See that? Gotta aim right between the horns. Good lad.
What did I do to you? Why are you trying to get my horns in between them?
Shh. We're the robbers, and they're Prepare the watch. Ready? Aim.
This low rent Legolas ain't cutting it. Just the two of you? Ooh. What you got? More stuff. And there's another dead imp.
The only good imp's a dead imp.
I'm not seeing. Yeah, that's alright. Guess we'll go keep on going here. Gonna check on this dead thrall. And take out their gold, because they don't need no more. Just a couple of grave robbers, don't mind us. And my little brain buddy. I'm assuming this is the direction they would like us to go. How are you? Whatever. No, don't touch. That's disgusting. What is this? Mucous membrane. Size tiny? No. Sir, that is not tiny. That is a huge wall of mucus. It's disgusting. More messages? Nope, no messages. Just keep on walking over to this here, heart valve, apparently.
Istic, back.
Quit calling me that.
Without knowing its purpose.
Istic.
You're an Istic.
Alright, first I'm going to put away my weapons. It is not necessary in this scenario. I'm going to save, because I don't know quite what's going to happen. Ooh, we need to heal up. Let's do that. We're sharing the healing. Healing words. Gonna check this sigil. Shut up! He failed. Very intellect devourer friend, can you tell me what it means? You can't reach. Well, you're no help at all. What about you, friend? Can you read? No can read. Alright, next guy. What can you read here?
Can't read the script.
Jesus Christ, man. You're supposed to be smart. Unleash the beast? Push. I know that means unleash. Let's look around the room some more. Ooh, scrolls.
Checking out the scrolls.
Oh, which reminds me. Let me tell my own children to do this. Let's see here. Children. You guys should follow me. That's not what I said, but talk to text is imperfect at best. Scroll of false life. Scroll of inflict wounds. Burnished necklace? Elaborate. I always mispronounce words. I'm not very good with English. Ooh, they're eating dinner.
I wish I had dinner. Oh, I have these damn crackers.
Yeah. I want to examine it. Elaborate reliquary. Mispronounced it. Made of precious stone and covered in gold. It's just both sturdy and pleasing to the eye and worth a whole flippin' lot. Yeah. Yes, open it. Bright and polished, this necklace was clearly cherished by its previous owner. I think I have a new pretty necklace that I have to put on. Slap it on, brother. There we go. Nobody else gets my necklaces. What does she say? Nothing. What do you say? Nothing. You basic. Ooh, a backpack. Sure. After I check out this backpack, that's probably your stuff. Heck yeah. There's always stuff in a backpack.
Lady, for the love of God, shut up!
You! Get me out of this damn thing!
I have no time for stragglers.
You're a straggler. There's magic. Look for last time I was there. There's magic at work here, but what kind? Roll McRolly. Come on. An upside down six.
Wide open unless they're destroyed.
look for a lighter metal than this.
Try to disrupt the bright lines of magic with a touch.
With just a wee touch.
Whoa, it's a hot stove.
Satisfied? We need to go.
Leave the one. The one must be left.
Jesus, you're a bunch of...
Wait! There can't be. There has to be another way. Please!
It cannot be helped. Come.
Safe if she stays. Safe if we go.
What does that mean? What the hell are you talking? What are you talking about?
You know what? There's stuff that I didn't come across this time around that I came across last time. Yeah, well. You know what I'm going to do is, even though I can't read this stuff...
Can't read the script.
Ooh, why am I sparky? Who's that? Do I have a special condition going on here?
Why am I sparkly?
I'm gonna press this button. Oh. Okay. Well, wasn't expecting that. Ooh, a candle. Did I kill her by accident? Maybe.
I will not die here. I cannot.
Game's giving me literally no options. And I already know, because I tried before, you can't blow it up either. I very much so attempted so. You cannot blow it up. The seizures. Guess that guy's not my buddy.
Ooh.
How many hosts of these gay infected?
Well, why don't we just ask them?
Let's sit in these fancy chairs that apparently hurt my butt. Though it seemed, what's this?
A dazed woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you.
Trying to get better with my lip syncing.
She doesn't. Oh, senpai. Senpai, notice me.
Perfect.
Perfect. But it failed? What are you talking about? Drained cleric. Is there any other kind?
A beautiful wrought golden key plucked from a bloody corpse.
I mean...
Might fit that chest.
That might be your opinion. Sure. Oh, they just switched places. Guess it means we can't do it.
I've got some magic stuff.
Magical as in the friends we made along the way.
Perfect.
I will push the giant green button
and cause a horrifying reaction. Is it like an alien movie? I got the same pants on, lady. Chewing on the wrong side of my mouth.
She's having a baby. She is the baby.
Change her. Change to the pull of a lever.
I'm offended by these slurs.
If we are not purified, this may be our fate.
I mean, he is ripped.
The newborn mind flayer stares at you, weak and dazed.
Dazed and confused.
All right. Well, guess all I can do over there. So long, story background thing, Bob. My phone. Who's messaging me? No, I am not expecting anything from FedEx. Thank you, spam. What country is it they consider like the national food spam? Somebody tell me that.
I don't recall.
And we're going up to another prolapsed asshole.
Woohoo! What's over here?
Ooh, fancy lad. Ooh, it worked that time. Good job, graphics. Why does it sound like Mr. Spacely?
Connect the nerves of the transponder. We must escape now.
Alright.
Do it. We will deal with the gake after we escape.
The gake?
Connect the nerves.
Nerves? We will connect them.
Ew, you're mucusy. Commits battle.
Oh no, it's a flying imp. Whatever shall we do? Let me just do a little dippy dip.
Fire! Krakatoa! Krakatoa! Whee! I want that crossbow. That is the type of weapon that Anku used.
We need to get out of here.
Ooh, brain.
Got brains?
Too high. How you talking if you stun, son? Let's see here. Why does everybody get to go except for Anku?
Was he surprised again?
You missed. Well, the only thing we can do in a situation like that is a push.
Back off, son.
Whee! My baby! My baby brain!
Claw him! Claw his eyes out like the sassy cat, yeah. I guess that's the end of your turn. Check these bodies. Check these bodies. I'm just gonna keep checking the bodies.
I can't move any further. Or can't go any further. I just shoot a bow at this here gore. Just 1 point.
How did you only hit him for 1 point? That doesn't even make sense in the terms of the game mechanics. Anyway. Like, roll like 1d6 plus your proficiency plus your... Anyway. It's almost like this isn't a perfect transition. Yeah, go check the body. Take the weapon, and then slash a dish guy. Now, shove him into the hole.
If this ship hits the ground, we're dead.
And the brain can check bodies too? What? What's this? That's something? Is there stuff in this room that can be collected right now? Let's see.
It's a table.
Yeah, you can't reach it unless I jump. I guess you can't jump. Okay, never mind. Never mind. Just go this way. End of your turn. Anything else that I can check that body? Check every... Dude, check. Because I am a scavenger. I'm starting to understand.
He's a dead.
I believe that's all I can do. This fighting music is kind of relaxing. Not nearly as tense as
I want the crossbow.
Well, since I can't go any further, unless I use a dash. Yeah! Get that stuff.
Connect the transponder.
I heard you the first time, brother. I heard you the first time. You don't have to keep reminding me. You pushy pandy. I guess that's the end of her stuff. Any other bodies to check? I don't trust this game with their secrets. There's stuff up here. A chest. I'm a pirate and I'm always looking for a sunken chest. A big booty chest. Alright, fine. And he will fire an arrow at this guy. Thwink! And did they hit? Good for you, brother. It's my brain buddy and me. He's gonna check this body at 3. Nothing. Yeah, give him a wide bath.
We connect the transponder.
Oh wait, I should have let him speak. Ooh.
Ignore the devil. We must take the transponder.
Fine.
Well, first, you need a second win. So take care of that. Boom. Only 3 points. That sucked. Fight! You thwacked him, lady. You thwacked him real good. Ha! She had blur lines and everything. It was here. And ooh, can I make him do the transponder? I hope so. Ha ha! Made you waste your reaction. Just like I always want to. And your back is turned. Fool!
Boom.
He loves to spam that ability.
My baby brain!
Whack him real good. Shove his booty. Bop! And then, oh, so she can move. Good for her. It's almost like I meant to do that, which would be a lie. Claw his eyes out like the sassy one you are.
Whee!
For no reason. And this guy, really far behind. Yes, turn your back on me. I'm not a threat.
I lied.
Quite good at lying. Who's about to die here? Who's losing this fight? Yeah, they're pretty even actually. Well, percentage wise, the devil's losing, but you know. Yeah. Didn't really get to explore, did I? Ooh, is this a chest? Are you 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 a chest? Is anything a chest? Eh, fine. I'll go press the flipping button. Oh no, she's gonna press the button.
The Helms alien transponder. You made it.
No, she made it in time, not me. Big difference.
Eww.
Hey guys! It smells like something's cooking over here. You having a potluck? You didn't invite me? Should have been wearing pants. Fireproof pants. Those graceful legs. Love it.
Whee!
Concussion number one. Red your A. Oh, no, whoa. Where's baby brain? Where's everybody else? Oh, maybe I should move that, make it more cinematic.
Must grab the phallus. The wobbly sausage.
Shar and Saloon fight a divine war of darkness versus light. Their worshippers mirror this crusade and conflicts across Felain.
Both the living and the dead have plenty to say, but corpses won't be inclined to speak to the killers.
I mean, that's how I feel. Now, I kind of like the way that guy looks. I like the cut of his jib.
Passive checks can reveal hidden details in the world around you.
Too late. Oh, this licky lady. Look at that. Look at them. Look at that knee.
I see you. And
all audio settings can be adjusted under the options menu. All.
Shadowheart. Oh no, I already know her name. I gave away everything. I know too much about it.
Whee!
Ah yes, this weird moment.
Hey guys, that's not a normal star.
I sure do not like wearing a shirt. I like feeling the breeze on my nipples. My very sensitive nipples. That looks like my third nipple before I had it removed. What do you think?
Well, I mean, you know, you never speak to me.
You guys never speak to me either.
I don't like talking. Get the fuck out of here. So I continue to sniff the air.
Alright.
Come on, guys, I'm sick of this place. Let's get the hell out of here.
Hey, it's still there. I thought when I turned around, it was going to disappear, but just...
Wee!
Whoa!
All right, Thelma. I got it, Louise.
Wow. Not even a saving throw, just... Whacked in the head. Can't do nothing about it. You know, those ears are so big. Yep. Those emergency ears came into play.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
So many Dungeons & Dragons games, you start off with something inside your head. That was like the whole plot to Neverwinter 2, if I remember correctly. You hot something in your head. So what have I done so far?
We escaped hell in the Nautiloid.
Good. Chapter 1. Find a way to remove the Mind Flayer parasite.
We escaped hell in the Nautiloid. Crashed somewhere back in the Material Plane.
Are you sure?
We need to explore the area and find a healer. Lazelle told us that the parasite in our heads would transform into Mind Flayers. We need to find a way to remove it.
Who's this we? You're alone.
Nobody loves you.
All right. Ooh, what is this? 90%. 90% what? 90% what? Anyway, what I'm gonna do is save the game. Let's go back to new save. Oh no, I forgot. I gotta click on. You know what? Just regular old Ravage Beach. That's fine. I'm not in the mood to be creative right now. Then we're going to temporarily stop the session because I need to check something. Hopefully this works.